Today, we have decided to have a Vishnu Maya Puja. In this context, one has to know who is this Vishnu Maya and what is her, you can call it mythological, but a historical relationship. I have told you that America is the country of Sri Krishna. And he is Kubera as well as he is Yama. Because he is Kubera, people have got their affluence. They are rich people, they have money more than anywhere else. But if you do not remember that you have to have balance and that Sri Krishna's power is of Mahalakshmi. So Mahalakshmi principle is such that where seeking is important. Vishnu principle is there when Sri Lakshmi is his power. After getting the Lakshmi up to a certain point, then you jump into a new awareness or a new sort of a seeking, which is the seeking of the spirit, where the Mahalakshmi principle starts, the central path. That far, of course, in America it started, the Mahalakshmi principle. But people did not know, they had no discretion to know which way to go for their seeking. And so many got enamored by false advertisements, but all kinds of promises, claims and things. And I came here long time back at that moment where I knew that the seeking now is showing results and that all the people from all over the world will try to come down here because there was a market for them. And their marketing will start in such a manner that these people who are used to marketing will fall into it. I came, I tried, I told them, just call people. So this is exactly what happened in America, that I came here, I think I was the first to arrive. I warned them, I told them names of the people who will be doing all this kind of work. Also I told them what were they in their last lives, what kind of a thing they did, what kind of work they did, what are their negative powers and how they try to manipulate. But nobody would listen to me. Because these people found out that the weaknesses of Americans, if you can pamper them, pamper their ego and tell them that this is something very important that you should do something that is very superficial, but something looks fantastic. As I told you that they said you can fly 3 feet height. And the Americans took to it. All such absurd ideas, they took to it, because they thought it was something new, something different. And they wouldn't listen to me because I said, I won't take money. And they told me very clearly that nobody will understand you if you don't take money. So I said, how much will you pay me? It is so invaluable. How much money are you going to pay me? And they had no answer. So those people who were still money-oriented, so the Mahalakshmi principle was not in them to understand that if you have to seek the truth, you cannot pay for it. They couldn't understand that. And that is how they had to go through all this circle of facing all kinds of false gurus, all types, all superficial things. Ultimately, now I think, first year I feel everything has come up very well. But one of the chakras of this Vishuddhi is, as you know, very important, is the left Vishuddhi. And the left Vishuddhi is the center. If it is caught up, you get angina, you get spondylitis, and also you get lethargic organs. So this left Vishuddhi has been a sort of a fashion with the Western people. Maybe because of Christianity, where you had to confess and you have to say you are a sinner and you are a born sinner or original sinner, all kinds of things. So as you are branded as sinner, you see, you always felt guilty. And that guilt was built in the left Vishuddhi. I think this is one of the greatest drawback even today, that people in America feel extremely guilty for very small things, because they have no confidence in themselves. Firstly, they think that we are a very young nation, we had no tradition, basically. They may look arrogant, they may look to be very show-offs, but basically inside they feel that we have had no tradition, we are a very young nation. They think that the English are too over sophisticated, or the French are very sophisticated, and we are not compared to them, we are primitive. This kind of a funny ideas they have. And because of this, you see, they try to make up. And to make it up, the path they followed ended up into all kinds of things, and it built up a very huge left Vishuddhi in them. That's why Americans are having so many problems of the left Vishuddhi. First of all, this center catches when you do not want to face your mistakes. I've committed the mistakes, all right, I've committed it, now I'm not going to do it, and why I committed and why it happened, just face it. They don't want to. They will feel guilty that we have done this, or I've put it here. Like they go on amassing, like very black clouds of guilt. Then this Vishnumaya, who is the thunder, we can call, who is the electrical charge which is liberated by the friction of these black clouds, which actually is a catalyst for rain. It's a catalyst for rain. This start acting on such people. That is, they suddenly get a shock. They become extremely sensitive people. They get nervous. And this nervousness makes them think, why are we nervous? What is the problem? Like the exposure of their guilt comes through the Vishnumaya power. I have to tell you about also the origin of Vishnumaya, which is very interesting. Vishnumaya was the sister of Sri Krishna, who was born after Sri Krishna was born. Actually, she was not his own sister, but she was the daughter of Nanda. And when Sri Krishna was taken over and was put in the care of Nand and Yashoda, they gave their own daughter in his place. And the father of Sri Krishna brought it back. So, when Kansa came, the uncle, you all know about the story, to ask about the eighth child, they said, "This is the child." He said, "But this is not a man, this is a woman." He took the child in his hand and did like this and threw it in the sky. And there she went and there she announced that Sri Krishna is already incarnated, he is living and he is your killer. So she is the announcer. She is the announcer of the incarnations. She is the announcer of something good that is going to happen. Also she is the one who can burn things which are not spiritually all right. At the time of Mahabharata, she was born as Draupadi. And this Draupadi was the sister of Sri Rama. And when, as you know in Mahabharata, all of you know the story of Mahabharata, I need not tell that, Duryodhana tried to take out her clothes. Then she called for Krishna. First she said, "Kree," she put her teeth like this. Till she said, "Krishna," it was there. Because she was thinking if she says "Shna," the thing will fall down and she will become exposed. As soon as she said "Krishna," the thing fell down. And that's the time Sri Rama came, all the Sri Krishna came all the way from Dwarika. And Tulsidas ji has described it very well in Hindi language, "Dwarika me shor bhayo." In Dwarika, there was a big noise, you can call it, or what, I don't know, shor bhayo bhari, tremendous. What you call, the thunder, you can call it. Because she was the one who is responsible for thunder. Shora bhayo bhari, shankha chakra gada padma garuda lai sidari. With a shankha, with chakra, with garuda, with padma, all of them, he came on the garuda. With all his weapons, he came on a garuda to help her. He started supplying the saris to her, and this Duryodhana got absolutely, Dushasana did that, got absolutely tired and he fell on the ground. So now here Vishnu Maya is the one who is the virgin. Not only that she is a virgin, but she exists in all the five elements. Has shown that she married five Pandavas. And that this power of virginity in her used to expose people to the dangers of these horrible Kauravas who were going to rule and destroy the dharma. So she stood back and she is the one who said that you have to fight. You have to fight for dharma, whatever may happen. And Krishna always supported her. So as a brother, Sri Krishna supported her. So the relationship between brother and sister are very important in India. Also should be with Sahyogis, because we have Rakhi Bandhan, we also have what you call the Bhaiyadwij, where on Diwali day we tie up a Rakhi to the brother. Now this Rakhi is nothing but the Vishnu Maya's power, which protects the brother. Actually there the brother protected her and now the sister's love protects the brother. So the relationship between brother and sister is much more important than any other relationship, because it's so pure, it's so protective, it's so loving, and also it is of an equal age. For example, between the parents and the children cannot be that. I say, between the grandparents and the children can be quite imbalanced also. But between the brother and sister, they are the same age group, same understanding. And this relationship is maintained by this Vishnu Maya. We have a very good incident of that in India, which I must tell you how this Rakhi Bandhan or this relationship between brother and sister is respected. I mean, nobody will believe, because in these countries where there is no relationship which is respected, we won't understand. But when Alexander the Great came to India, he conquered our country quite a lot. But there was one king, Puru, who defeated him and put him in jail. Alexander had married an Indian lady. So it was the day of this Rakhi Purnima. She put one Rakhi in one plate and covered it up and sent it to this King Puru. So they said, a Rakhi has come. So the king said, all right, tie up the Rakhi. He didn't know whose Rakhi it was. When it was tied, he said, whose Rakhi it was? It's your sister's. Who is my sister? She is the wife of this king, Alexander. Oh my God! How could I do such a thing? He is my brother-in-law. He immediately went to the jail and prostrated before him. He said, I'm sorry. This is the graciousness, you understand. How could I be so stupid as to arrest you? Alexander was flabbergasted. He couldn't understand his reaction. He said, what's this going on? And he said that, now, I ask for your forgiveness and please come out with great pomp and show, with ornaments for his sister and all that. He sent the brother-in-law home. Now this Alexander could not understand. He went in and his wife was smiling. He said, what's the matter? How am I here? She said, do you know, I have saved you with one thread. She showed him a Rakhi. With this thread you saved me, how? She said, you know what is today? Is a day when a sister can tie this to a brother and the brother has to do what sister wants. So I said, I sent it to this Puru, the king, and he has released you. Alexander thought, what sort of people these Indians are? On one thread they release such an enemy like me, how can I rule these people? They'll put me out any time, so symbolic they are. He said, all right, I'm sorry. He took one fellow called Vardai, Chanda Vardai, took him down, he was a poet with him, and he said, now you write poetry, because Indians are very subtle people, you know, I can't understand. How can they release such a horrible enemy like me only on a thread? Such trust, such understanding of a brother for a sister. And the sister has to keep the trust also. So now when we go deeper into it and see for ourselves our Vishuddhi problems is this, that we always try in the West to feel guilty and get out of our mistakes. For small things feel guilty, people, because the norms in the Western life are so rigid, like if you put a spoon on the other side, finished. I mean, what does it matter? You can take it on this side and eat it. If you spill some coffee, then that guilt will last all your life. After all, coffee is to be spilled. If it is hot, it can happen, some accident can take place. The guilt business is so great, that nobody corrects oneself, just go on feeling guilty, 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 guilty. And all the subtleties of life you start missing. In Sahaja Yoga especially, to feel guilty means all your left side is caught up. You cannot feel the vibrations properly because this is the cervical nerve on which your guilt is sitting and is just clamping it. You cannot feel the left side. You start catching on the left side till you receive some sort of a horrible disease. Then you realize. The subtler part of this Vishnu Maya is that she knows the truth. When she shines, you can see everything. Even for a short time, she exposes in the darkness everything. In the same way, when Vishnu Maya starts acting on you, then she exposes the truth to you. But supposing you continue with your left Vishuddhi too much, then she just disappears. She is not there to correct you, to help you in any way or to expose you. Then you don't feel anything. You become numb on the left side, absolutely numb on the left side. And the left side is the indicator of all kinds of left side diseases. This is one of the reasons that we have the maximum number of left-sided diseases in the West than in India. Indian diseases are from right side, while the left-sided diseases come from this left Vishuddhi. So to feel guilty itself is wrong and is a mythical thing. Now you feel guilty for something. What's the use of feeling guilty? It's just a myth. It's an empty thing you are carrying upon yourself. No use feeling guilty. If you think you have done something wrong, just face it. That I have done this wrong and I will not do it again. But if you feel guilty, then you see it's like a stored up stuff there. And then again you do the same mistake. Again you do the same mistake. And you become immune. Immunity you develop. Then we start not even feeling that it is wrong, you know. People do wrong things even without thinking that it is wrong. Even that consciousness, or you can say that alertness, is finished. Then you think, what's wrong? For anything, this is a very good answer, what's wrong? It's like a drunkard. He starts drinking, first he feels, oh, I should not have drunk. Then he starts little bit more, then little bit more, little bit more. Ultimately he says, what's wrong? If I am drinking, it's perfect. Anything of that kind starts with left Vishuddhi. Because we do not face the mistake. It's not true that because your tradition has been very short or anything, it's only thing your attitude. Because it is Krishna's place, especially for Americans, it is very important to face their mistakes and to admit, all right, I have done this mistake and I am not going to do it. So because they do not want to admit, they put up this arrogant behavior. I know underneath this arrogant there is somebody who is very guilty. They are actually here very collective also. Very correct. In the sense they will be worried about Vietnam, Korea, everything. Anything happens in the world, they are worried about. They are the ones who started UN and every sort of thing. Everything is there. But despite all that, this guilt business makes them very insensitive. Very insensitive to things which are reality. Anything which is negative, they should face that thing as negative that they don't face. They will support a country which is despotic, despite the fact they are a democratic country. all such things, not only in politics but also in day-to-day life. Then the whole thing becomes such a lifestyle. It becomes a lifestyle, the whole thing becomes collective. Nobody ever can come and say that this is something we are doing wrong and we should stop it. If somebody says that, oh, they say he's mad, he's no good. For Freud, I was telling you that Freud was denounced by many people and people gave some papers, everything happened, but nobody would listen to them. And the same thing happened with Sergio also. They would not listen to me because they have developed an immunity against reality. In everything, whatever is real, they become immune. They don't want to face it. That's too much. Much too much for me. With this kind of an attitude, they had to work out something else, and in that they have gone to the right side. With that they have developed all kind of machinery, science, all this, everything. But science is not conclusive. It cannot give you the totality, it cannot give the reality. So, this Vishnu Maya shows her strength. She does lots of things by which people are frightened. She can enter into any element. She can permeate. Supposing she enters into a water element, she can create a typhoon. She can create any kind of disaster. She can enter into Mother Earth and she can create a earthquake. She can do anything because she has a power to enter into anything. You know that she can enter into Mother Earth very easily. She can enter into water very easily. And when she gets into it, she becomes the catalyst. And all these problems that you are facing today in America are because of left Vishuddhi, because of Vishnu Maya. I'm happy today's program has been arranged for Vishnu Maya, because this is the power which you Sahajyogis should be able to harness and should be able to worship, so that she sees all of you there and she looks after you and she maintains your life and looks after you. Now the most difficult thing is to convince people in America that money is not everything. You may have any amount of money, you may have any amount of so-called pleasures, everything, but still you can never be satisfied and you can never be at peace with yourself and you cannot generate peace. Money cannot replace reality. It's just there. Now, the problem is that people become so addicted to this money that all value systems start flowing down. I was surprised, I knew somebody here who took his own sister for prostitution. So I said, what's this? What are you doing? What's wrong? We'll get money. So whatever can get money, they indulge into. So there's no chastity, which is the basics, which is the foundation of human beings. As a result, when you insult this virginity of Vishnu Maya, then the Maya means the her play is that you get AIDS, you get all kinds of other diseases which are incurable and which are what you can call as the secret diseases. Because she is the virgin, And because she respects the virginity, and those who go against, not that virginity is meant only for women, also meant for men, because everybody has here left Vishuddhi. Here the idea is that only the virginity is word used for women only. It's not. Even the men who do not respect their virginity, their chastity, are attacked by Vishnu Maya in different ways. I am not surprised that Los Angeles, they say, is in danger all the time. Because of your cinemas you produce, all these things you produce. Of course, I mean, now with the Sahaja Yoga being established very well in Los Angeles, things may be averted. But still, it's very dangerous. This is the one of the most powerful shakti is this of Vishnu Maya. Because she plays the illusion, she creates the Maya also. Also she breaks the Maya, and she can burn anything. Your forest is burning now, 65 hectares of land is burning. Who has done this? It's nothing but Vishnu Maya. Nobody has to take any matchbox for that. She can burn anything. And her burning gives you the feeling that if there's an electrical charge, as if burnt with electrical charge. This is very true. In so many cases I've seen those who came to me with problems of left Vishuddhi, that they said that we think there's some electrical charge coming out of here, as if it's the burning of an electrical shock. This is Vishnu Maya's doing, and she's the one who is the corrector. She corrects. Don't feel guilty. Face your problems. It's sort of when we hide our mistakes in the name of guilt, when we try to camouflage it, she's the one who exposes it on individual level, on collective level, on national level, international level. Because she can permeate into anything. And this permeation of hers gives her such subtleties. But people cannot relate disaster to their mistakes. They cannot. They don't understand why such a disaster has taken place, what has happened. There was a big typhoon that came up to a point and suddenly turned towards Kauai. Now what was the reason for that, to go and hit Kauai? In Kauai there is a Swayambhu of Shiva, it's a fact. People are making money out of it, quite a lot of money, and deceiving people, there's big business going on in the name of Shiva. So, Kauai was it, not Hawaii so much as Kauai. And it turned suddenly, no one can understand that. So all these thundering things that are coming from nature, anything, whether it is earthquake or it is landslide or it could be floods or it could be typhoon, anything is the work of this Vishnu Maya. Or we can say all natural catastrophes are brought about by this Vishnu Maya. She has this power to do it. This is the only way they can shock people. But despite all that shocking, people have to relate these disasters to their mistakes that they have committed and have nicely kept it here, not facing. I've heard from some Indian students that when they came to America, some boys asked them to take drugs and do all other things also. So they know the city of goody goodies, this, that, you know, they just pumped it into their head that you have to do it, you are cowards, you cannot do it and all that. So some of them said, all right, we'll try. But what surprised them, that they knew it was wrong, while those who were telling them never thought it was wrong. They thought they have been great martyrs or they have been liberators and they have got liberties. They couldn't understand this. This kind of liberty that they were boasting of was so destructive. They'd never understood that this is destructive. So once your left vishuddhi is absolutely jammed, you lose complete discretion of the chakra here, which we call as hamsa chakra. And then you do not know what is destructive, what is constructive. You start accepting mostly the destructive thing if your left vishuddhi is bad. Escape. So what? What wrong? That is how violence has come. That is how all kind of cheating, corruption has come. What's wrong? Because if you do anything wrong, you put it there, finished, stored up. Again you do anything, you put it there. And till you become absolutely immune to all destructive action, you go on. So to get out of it, what to do? To get out of this horrible state where you do not feel any thing wrong, what is the thing? Is only is to take to Sahaja Yoga in a right fashion. First of all, you must face yourself. If you start facing yourself, you will realize that you have committed a mistake. So this is the mistake I have committed, doesn't matter. I am not going to feel guilty about it. If I ever have to do this, I will not do it. And I am not guilty for whatever has happened, is the past finished. With this faith in yourself, you can definitely get rid of your left vishuddhi. The problem is, even if I tell you something, I am worried that you start feeling guilty about it also. I mean, I am telling you for something for your correction. Then you start guilty, that, mother is saying so, see, I did this and all, but that you did. At this moment, what I am telling you, never to do it again. And face it. Whatever you did is finished and gone and is forgiven completely. Otherwise Vishnu Maya will take over. This is very important because one side is a leela, it's a play, and it's all the world is beautiful. The another side is the guilt. So we think that by just feeling guilty, we are solving all our problems. And this side we are enjoying ourselves, and this, the guilt part, is just like a storehouse of a garbage being put there. But we never think this garbage, what it is wrong it is doing to us. And this is what it is, that Vishnu Maya has to burn this garbage. Then she works in her own ways, in her own Maya ways, and so many things happen. Like there was a lady, and she was very right-sided. She used to dominate everyone, but nobody dared tell her that, because if you tell her, she would come back on you. So nobody wanted to tell her what's wrong with her. They said, all right, let it be now. But I told her that, see, you are very right-sided, you are dominating everyone, everybody is frightened of you. So she said, no, mother, I am not. I said, all right, I am telling you. You better believe me or you are in for trouble. And that very day, she was getting down from the staircase and she felt from top to bottom, she came down. And all her right side, she came to, mother, see, my right hand is broken, my right leg is broken, this is broken, that is broken. I said, then you know what happened? I now know why it has happened. Then I cured her. She was all right. But what I'm trying to tell you, that she wouldn't listen to me. So the right-sided people have a special capacity to put everything here. So I always say that it is the by-product of ego. Those people who try to dominate, who try to be angry, try to control everyone, they put it down there and then the whole thing works against them. This is to be understood in a very serious manner, that feeling guilty is not that you are harming yourself, but you are harming all others. Also this Vishnu Maya gets very upset with two other things. One of the things is smoking. If you smoke too much, then this Vishnu Maya gets very angry. She is the one who then causes cancer. She can spoil your throat. I mean, all kinds of ear, nose, throat problems can come in with the smoking. Because she doesn't like that smoke. She once, twice, thrice. But once you start smoking, then after some time, oh, what's wrong? They will quote, such and such man who is 83, he still smokes. See, quoting like this, they have ideas like that. Then you have also some cinema heroes, such and such man, see, he murdered his wife, he's not, see, he's going along. So we should also murder. We should also smoke. So the all ideals which have destroyed themselves become our ideals. And we start exactly doing what they are doing, without knowing that how they are destroyed, we'll be also destroyed. So this understanding about Vishnu Maya's powers should be there with us. That if we try to continue with our mistakes and putting them here, then first thing we become vulnerable to all kinds of diseases. With that, if you have smoking, you can become also very much vulnerable to cancer of the throat. Another thing which people do not know is the mantras. If you go on saying any mantra, I mean in India there are people who will every day morning get up and say some mantra for about say 100 times, some say it at least 300 times, 500 times, they go on measuring mantra, 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 mantra like that. Now she is the mantrika, she is the one who gives the power to the mantra. Now if you are not connected to this divine power, then there's a short-circuiting take place. And if you go on saying this mantra, you develop all the troubles of the throat, throat cancer, you can develop also stomach in the stomach problems because it is Krishna and Vishnu are the same. You might develop also the problem of Virata. Because you are reciting a mantra like this, you see, a telephone, if it is not connected, I go on using it, the telephone will go out of order. In the same way, if you are doing wrong mantras, in the sense that the mantras which are said before your connection with the Divine, then they can spoil your left kshatriya very much. This is the style they use in India. Supposing you are a businessman in India. Now, you are a big businessman, you have made lot of money, now you feel guilty about it. Because you have made by bad means also, by all kinds of black market and all sorts of things. So they will make a big temple of Vishnu. Not Vishuddhi, but they will make a very big temple of Sri Vishnu. And they will create a kind of image that they are great religious people. Or they'll have khairat, means they will distribute food to people or distribute some things to people and feel satisfied. Here you go on committing any amount of sins, any amount of nonsense, and then out of that money you make a little contribution to Sri Vishnu, thinking that Sri Vishnu will be very happy and will not punish them. But he is Kubera, what can you give it to him? He is the Kubera. He gives you all the money, he does everything. So how can you give anything to Kubera, who is himself the lord of wealth? It's a very common thing in India, like there was a Bhudan thing. I knew of a man who was very corrupt, very bad person. I mean, really, he was really very, very bad man. And he had taken away so much land from the poor farmers and all that. So he gave one land to Mahatma Gandhi. And this land, this Bhudan land was known. It was, I think, Vinobaji gave. This land was so bad that you could not put even cactus there. And he was telling everybody, I have given so much land to Bhudan, I have given so much land to Bhudan. So trying to sort of justify himself for taking all the land from the poor and lynching them and then to do this kind of a generosity. So this is another escape people have, that do what you like and ultimately be generous. This kind of gracious covering of your mistakes can be very misleading. It doesn't work with Vishnu Maya. She knows you out and out. And if you try all these tricks with her, she will show her own powers. I would say all our left side problems come because of Vishnu Maya power. She punishes you as well as she exposes, as well as she gives you light, as well as she corrects you. With all these powers of Vishnu Maya, we should be very thankful that today we are celebrating her special puja, because I think it is one of the curses of the West, especially of Americans, to feel guilty. So today you all have to promise in your heart, and the mantra is, now she also understands English perhaps, you can say that, Mother, I am not guilty at all. That's all. If that is said, she will be very happy, I am not guilty at all, I am not going to feel guilty. Once you stop feeling guilty, you will not do wrong things. Because how will you manage? Because you are not doing, you cannot put it as guilt. So what's the use of doing anything wrong? Do wrong, it comes on your head. You cannot put it in your left visuddhi. So you won't do anything wrong. You will immediately understand that if I have to do wrong, I have to face it. But if there's a space here kept where you can put your guilt for your wrongdoings available, then you don't mind so much. Supposing somebody has a small house, no place to store, then somebody brings something and says, no, no space here, I am already very full. It's like that. So the best thing is to have no guilt at any cost. I will have no guilt. If I have done mistake, all right, I'll admit I've done the mistake. And I'll have no guilt at all about it. I'll face it. You'll be surprised, you'll stop doing wrong things. Definitely you'll stop because there's no space left. So this is very important today to do Vishnu Maya's thing. And I'm sure now, very happy with the tour of America. This time I'm really happy because I think it has worked in most of the places very well. And if it has not worked, you should not feel guilty but face the problem, why it has not worked. And the problem lies with Sahaja Yogis and nobody else. Shouldn't blame anybody else for it, just see yourself what mistakes you must have committed. Could be a small or a big mistake, whatever it is, face it. There's no harm in saying, I've done mistake. But if you say, sorry, means it goes that straight forward. No, I have committed a mistake. To admit that is very gracious, very beautiful, and very kind to yourself for your benevolence. In Sahaja Yoga is one of the biggest mantras for all the Western people. They should all the time saying to all the trees, all the nature around, I am not guilty. Your ecological problem will improve. Because then you won't do wrong things to spoil your ecology. You'll be careful. Because you spoil it and you feel guilty. Oh, I should not have done this. Oh, I should not. But why did you do in the first place, is the point. So now, next time you're not going to do it. So many of our problems will be solved if you face them and correct them boldly. It's possible for Sahaja Yogis because you're separated from your being, you're away from it. You can see your body, you can see your mind, you can see your ego, you can see all of those things and you know how to put them right. You are not that, you know. So you are the Spirit. With the light of the Spirit you can correct all these things. But this guilt is something where it stops you completely from correcting or doing anything better about it or bringing any constructive thing to your own mind. This will solve many problems for America as well as for all the Western world. Same with the Indians, that they should not think that if they are generous a little bit, they can get rid of their mistakes, you see, they have to face it. It's a different style. Indians are very clever, you know, they know how to find excuses and escapes. But after all, it is Vishnu Maya. She will show you that there is no escape, just face it. There's no need to condemn yourself, don't need to in any way degrade yourself or to feel inferior. But to be superior as the Spirit, oh, I see, oh, I see. Like I would say, all right, Nirmala, I see you very well, huh? You did this. Separate yourself from yourself. You can talk on the mirror, you can go to the river and talk there, or you can go to an ocean and tell them that, see, I've done this mistake and now I'm not going to do it. You can make promises to all these elements. Once you make these promises, this Vishnu Maya will receive the message and she won't enter into any one of these elements to disturb you. So you have to go and tell the ocean that, all right, America is not guilty for whatever they have done. Say it like that. If you say, it's all right, not other people. Because I told you, your genetics have changed, you are different people. Whatever you say, Vishnu Maya will always believe in and everything will work out very well. But this is a special time, as I told you before, where we call it is the Krita Yuga, where between the Kali Yuga and Satya Yuga this time is so important that whatever mistakes we have committed, we have to pay for it. It's a karma phala. It won't work out by just putting it here. So one has to get to realization, change the genetics completely and then you can go and tell the nature that, all right, we are not guilty now, you've got our realization. And it will work. I'm sure so many of catastrophes of this country can be averted by you, Sahaja Yogis. May God bless you.